Good morning, Sandro. Good morning, Angel. Good morning. Good morning, Lauren. Good morning, Kathleen.
Good morning, Miss.
Good morning. Good morning, Lauren. Good morning, Angel. Good morning, Olivia. What date is today? October 13. Okay, directly list your attendance, yeah. Sandro, here, okay, thank you. Arvin, not yet. Azali, not yet. Jane, not yet. Kathleen, yes. Daryl, yeah. Angel, Joseph Angelina, okay. Ada not yet, Keiko, not yet. Okay, Azali here. Good morning, Azali. Good morning, Arvin. Okay, and then Keiko, not yet. Lauren, okay. And then Livia Yong, okay. Gio, not yet. Nando, okay. Valen not yet, Vanessa here, and then for the last Vincent. Okay, maybe we wait until 13, yeah, 13 or 14 participant. Okay, now before we start our activity, we want to lead the prayer first for the starting. One. Today number 13, because the date now is 13, 14 absence, 13 Nando, okay? Nando, you will lead the prayer, okay, thank you. And then 10 already, Lauren. And then maybe we want to close this meeting. We want to lead the closing prayer. No one? Okay, maybe later ya. Okay, masih 10. Where's the others? You do not know? Okay, maybe you can check your friends. If your friend late, you can ask your friends to join earlier ya. Hello Vanessa, where is your uniform? Okay. Okay, Nando, because your friends not join earlier, lebih awal ya. Nando mulai aja ya. I'll be sure this. Have you your own prayer? Not yet? Belum what? Okay. Oh, I see Vincent here. Good morning, Vincent. Okay, I will share the screen, yeah. And then Nando will lead us the prayer. And then all of you follow Nando to pray our Father as usual, yeah. Okay, Nando, I will pin you so your friends will see your face here. Okay, now can you see the screen? Okay. Okay, all of you, I want you to sit nicely, hold your hands. And then Nando will lead us the prayer. Okay, Nando, you may start.
In the name of the Father,
the Father,
the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Father in heaven, you love me. You are with me in
night and day.
Night and day. I want to love you always in all I do and say.
I try to please you.
Father, bless me to our this day.
Amen.
Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, the Holy Spirit. Amen. Okay, thank you Nando, and thank you everyone. Okay, and then I see some of your friends join. Good morning Adonia. Good morning Jane. Okay, Daryl here, not yet. And then Keiko, not yet. Chio, not yet. And then Valin. 1, 2, 3, 4. The fourth participant missing today ya. Maybe later. Okay. Nah, sebelum Miss Jane memulai dengan science, seperti biasanya Miss Jane akan memulai dengan pembiasaannya dulu ya. Nah, sebelum kita menyanyikan lagu Indonesia Raya dan Pancasila, Miss Jane mau tanya dulu. How was your project about the winter pipe? Is it difficult to make it? What the meaning of this term? Is it difficult or no?
It's not difficult.
It's not difficult because you have already know the video, yeah? How to make it. Okay, and then some of you, I already checked in your... Oh, Gio already here. Okay, today for the last submitted, ya, mission tunggu hari ini, kemarin harusnya ya, mission tunggu hari ini, yang masih belum, for the grade 6B, there is 1, 2, 3, 4. Four participants does not have finished yet about, or does not submitted yet this project. Jadi, 4 siswa yang masih belum bisa hubungi Miss Jane. Kenapa bisa telat? Ya, oke, yang merasa ya, nanti yang belum atau cek lagi Google Classroom-nya. Oh iya, ada tugas. Nah, nanti dicek lagi. Mission lihat ada 4 yang belum ya. Ini nanti bisa dikerjakan hari ini. Paling terakhir mission tunggu sampai besok malam. Ya, oke, nanti biar nilainya biar cepat masuk ke rapotnya juga. Karena sebentar lagi akan PAS. Cepat sekali, Michelle. Kan baru PTS ya. PAS-nya kapan? Ada yang tahu? Ada yang tahu? Akhir apa?
Akhir
November ya. Dimulai tanggal 29. Nah, kalian nanti bisa perkirakan ya. Harus tugasnya harus selesai sebelum tanggal berapa? Ya, sebelum tanggal-tanggal itu, sebelum PTS, sebelum PAS, semua tugas harus selesai. Jadi nanti setelah PAS sudah tidak ada lagi tugas-tugas yang menumpuk atau mencicil lagi. Jadi tidak perlu guru-gurunya atau miss-missnya atau misternya kontak-kontak kalian lagi. Jadi sebelum PAS harus selesai semua. Bisa ya. Tidak hanya sains, semua mata pelajaran. Mau tematik kelasnya Miss Mani juga. Kalau ada tugas-tugas segera diinfokan. Miss, saya sebenarnya belum ini, apakah bisa melanjutkan tugasnya atau nilainya yang masih belum puas dengan nilainya? Miss, saya boleh mengerjakan lagi. Nah, seperti itu. Oke? Bisa ya? Oke. Nah, Miss J, I see here Keiko and Daryl. Good morning, Keiko. Good morning, Daryl. Oke, Miss J masih belum lihat Gio ya. Gio and Valin. Oh, Valin ini as usual ya. Kenapa, Meli? Nih, Mission belum bisa menghubungi Valin ya. Oke, nah sekarang Mission akan mulai dengan pembiasaannya menyanyi lalu melanjutkan dengan Pancasila. Oke, siapa yang mau memimpin menyanyinya? Siapa? Adakah yang mau memimpin? Tidak ada? Bisa aja ya, biar cepat ya. Nanti kalian bisa istirahat lalu ke PE. Nah, hari ini materinya hanya sedikit. Kita akan melanjutkan materi selanjutnya dan mengisi summary and practice activity ya, science-nya. Untuk bahan kalian 2 minggu lagi ulangan. Karena minggu depan kalian libur. Ada yang tahu libur apa? Kelahiran Muhammad SAW ya. Ya, tahun baru Islam. Nah, di situ. Nanti minggu depannya kalian bisa ulangan. Oke. Halo Keiko, are you ready? Oke, nah Miss Jin akan mulai ya. Kalau suaranya Miss Jin sedikit bindeng-bindeng, ya mohon maaf ya. Oke, Miss Jin akan mulai menyanyi lagu Indonesia Raya. Semuanya sit nicely. Gak usah berdiri, gak apa-apa, duduk aja, tapi tegap ya. Oke, Miss Jin akan mulai. Hiduplah Indonesia Raya. Indonesia tanah airku, tanah tumpah darahku. Di sanalah aku berdiri, jadi pandu ibuku. Indonesia kebangsaanku, bangsa dan tanah airku. Marilah kita bersatu, Indonesia bersatu. Hiduplah tanahku, hiduplah negeriku, bangsaku, rakyatku, semuanya. Bangunlah jiwanya, bangunlah badannya. Hidup Indonesia Raya, Indonesia Raya, mereka, mereka tanahku, negeriku yang kucinta. Indonesia Raya, mereka, mereka, hiduplah Indonesia Raya. Indonesia Raya, mereka, mereka, tanahku, negeriku yang kucinta. Indonesia Raya, mereka, mereka, hiduplah Indonesia Raya. Terima kasih. Nah, ada adiknya atau siapa yang menyanyi juga ya ini ya? Atau tidak ada? Miss Jin mendengarkan ada beberapa tadi. Oh, enggak ada ya. Oke, berarti kelas sebelahnya Miss Jin menyanyi juga. Pembiasaan ya. Oke, Miss Jin akan lanjutkan dengan Pancasila. Nah, agar kalian mengerti poin-poinnya Pancasila, bisa diamalkan di kehidupan sehari-hari. Oke, silakan mulai ya. Kalian melanjutkan saja. Oke, Pancasila. Satu, ketuhanan yang Maha Esa. Dua, kemanusiaan yang adil dan beradab. Tiga, persatuan Indonesia. Empat, kerakyatan yang dipimpin oleh hikmat kebijaksanaan dalam permusyawaratan perwakilan. Lima, keadilan sosial bagi seluruh rakyat Indonesia. Oke, terima kasih semuanya. Nah, ke pembiasaan paginya tadi Miss Jin sudah info ya, ada beberapa info tugasnya teman-temannya kalian ada yang belum terkumpul, segera dikumpulkan. Lalu mungkin ada beberapa juga yang masih bingung kemarin ya, membuatnya wind turbine itu bagaimana. Nah, bisa diinfokan ke Miss Jane kalau masih bingung. Miss, ini susah kumpulkan videonya di Google Classroom. Nah, boleh langsung ke WA. Ya, nanti langsung dicantumkan nama dan kelasnya, nomor absen, kelas, dan nama. Nanti Miss Jane akan langsung input ke Google Classroom-nya nilainya ya. Karena sudah ada rekapannya Drive, jadi video-video kalian sudah Miss Jane masukkan ke Drive Drive. Jadi siapa yang tidak terkumpul, nah nanti ketahuan absen berapa ya. Di kelas 6B ada 4 anak, nanti bisa dicek sendiri di Google Classroom-nya, oke? Okay? Nah, oke. Okay. Now I want you to prepare. Now we will start with the science class. I want you to prepare your own book, page 75, in unit 4.2 and 4.3. We will discuss about this material, the two unit, the use subunit, and then for the last, before we close this meeting, we will discuss about summary and practice. Have you checked or have you answered? Have you already answered about the summary and practice? Just Kathleen? Only Kathleen? Some of you? Not yet? Oh, maybe we will discuss it, yeah? Okay, now, for the first, I want you to open your book, page 75. And what do you know about this unit? What we learn about this unit? If you already read your book, I think all of you know what we talk about in this unit. About the invention with the electricity and magnetism. Jadi seperti inovasi, invention itu sebuah ini ya sesuatu yang baru dengan atau alat dengan menggunakan electricity atau magnetism. Nah di situ ada nanti contohnya bendanya elektromagnet. Kita akan belajar tentang elektromagnet. Nah harusnya di sini ada project, tetapi kemarin karena kalian sudah membuat projectnya wind turbine is okay. Nah hari ini kita akan discuss about the answer the, about the question and answer only about the summary and practice. Nah today for the first unit 4.2 invention with electricity and magnetic here. And now in page 75 you know about the table here ya, the mind map. The mind map about the electricity, magnetism, and electromagnetism. Nah, present a report on different ways of saving energy. How you save the energy or how you save the electricity, including the use of alternative energy source atau yang termasuk dengan energi alternatif. And then conduct and present the result of experiment with electricity and magnetism. Nah, karena kemarin harusnya project. Nah, kemarin sudah Miss Jane tidak ada project di elektromagnetism ini. Okay. Now, what do you know atau what do you remember about the electricity and magnetism? Where you can find the electricity? The main electricity. Where you can find the main electricity?
In a wall socket?
In the wall socket. Nah, maybe and then where you can produce, where to produce the main electricity, where we can produce the electricity, power plant, the power plants, and then the power plants transfer the electricity to the power lines and then go through the wall socket in your home or in your public places, and then you can get the electricity for your electrical appliances, ya. Jadi dialirkan dari power plants, lalu dialirkan ke power lines, and then go to your home, your public seat, public rail, public, what is called the public area, and then go to the wall socket, right? And then you can get the electricity from that. Now, and how about how you can get the magnetism? Magnet, how you can produce the magnet? Maybe the simple one with the electrostatic.
By stroking.
Yes, Kathleen.
By stroking.
By stroking, yeah, and then where you can find the simple magnet or the simple electrostatic. Nah, electrostatic about the magnetism. Right. What is the example of electrostatic? Give the example about the electrostatic. Listrik statis apa kemarin?
Rub a plastic roller on your hair.
Okay. And then your will hair your up, yeah. Bring your hair will up. Okay, rub your plastic or rub the comb, the plastic comb. And then the ruler, the plastic ruler. And then put on the your hair. Nanti bisa. Okay, now here. Electricity is the set of physical phenomena associated with the present. A presence and motion of matter that has a property of electric charge. Nah, itu adalah physical phenomena. Jadi sudah ada di sini electricity itu. And then electricity is related to magnetism. Jadi listrik itu juga ada hubungannya dengan magnet. Keduanya menjadi fenomena yang namanya electromagnetism described oleh Maxwell. Jadi nanti di SMP, ya, in junior high, you will learn about the Maxwell formula atau Maxwell equation. Jadi ada hukum atau Maxwell law, hukum Maxwell. Jadi ada rumus sendiri, rumus kimianya ya, rumus biologinya kalau tidak salah Miss Jim ya. Nah di sini. Maxwell equation. Maxwell first used the equation to propose that light is an electromagnetic phenomena. Jadi cahaya itu juga termasuk elektromagnet. Nah, cahaya inilah apa? Ringan dan beratnya. Ringan dan beratnya benda. Nah, kalian bisa lihat di buku in your book page 77 Making Electromagnet. Nah, kan ada sekarang untuk mengangkat like this. If you want to get the mission banyak lihat di daerah Perak ya, like the harbor. Nah, itu ada peti kemas. Bagaimana orang-orang kok bisa mengangkat peti kemas itu? Nah, itu ada alatnya, pakai elektromagnetik di alatnya, jadi bisa keangkat. Karena the material for this box from the metal. Nah, metal can attract the magnet. Sama seperti yang kelas 5 dulu. Karena besi itu bisa menempel di magnet. Jadi gampang diangkatnya. Nah, the electromagnet is different from of ordinary magnet. Jadi beda, elektromagnet itu berbeda dengan magnet itu sendiri. Ada listriknya kalau magnetnya itu ya. Dibantu oleh listrik, makanya Maxwell tadi bilang ada elektromagnetik, jadi ada magnet juga ada listrik. Nah, elektromagnet, nah di sini ya, the simple one, you can maybe you can make a experiment if you have the battery positive and negative, and then you have the wire. Wire didapatkan dari mana? Ini wire yang di dalamnya ya. Dalamnya kabel. Kalau ada kabel, nah kan ada plastiknya, the plastic cover of the kabel. You have to peel first. Jadi harus dibuka dulu, baru kalian dapat elektromagnetnya di situ. Kalau kalian hubungkan dengan nih, the wrapping a copper wire first. Nah, jadi harus dilepas dulu kulit kabelnya itu, lalu di spiralkan seperti ini ya, digulung-gulung around an iron pole such as a nail. Oke, Kathleen.
Wait, if we peel off the plastic part, that means we're gonna get electrocuted by it.
Yes, you have to peel off first the plastic first. Jadi kan ada kalau kabelnya mana ya, Miss Celia?
I don't have the sample here.
Kan ada kabel yang biasanya putih. Kabel putih. Nah, itu cari kabelnya yang baja. Jadi bukan yang bukan serbuk. Jadi kan ada kabel itu yang serbuk, ada serbuk, ada yang ini kaku. Nah, itu cari yang kaku, warnanya lebih kayak seperti tembaga. Nah, nanti kalian bisa lihat di YouTube ya atau di Google. Ini kabelnya memang yang harus tembaga, bukan yang serbuk. Kalau serbuk biasanya untuk yang kabel telepon, kabel internet, itu serbuk-serbuk. Serbuk itu artinya dia banyak, banyak kabelnya. Atau banyak apanya ya, alirannya, salurannya. Tapi kalau yang ini hanya dipakai itu hanya satu seperti ini. Nah, biasanya ini di kabel-kabel yang memang untuk listrik yang besar-besar seperti ini. Kalau laptop itu serbuk ya, kalau mouse juga serbuk. Nanti Miss Yen akan berikan contohnya gambar untuk ini ya, the picture of this wire yang cocok untuk membuat elektromagnet. Nah, lalu pakai iron nail. Iron nail itu apa?
Paku.
Nah, paku. Nah, lalu itu kalian lilitkan wire-nya tadi ke paku di positif ya, kutub negatif dan positif. Lalu kalian dekatkan dengan another nail. Kalian dekatkan dengan jarum boleh atau dengan yang lainnya lah. Itu bisa jadi magnet. The simple magnet. The simple electromagnet. Karena di dalamnya baterai ada apa? Have the chemical materials here ya. Baterai ada bubuk kimianya. Serbuk kimia. Jadi inilah chemical energy. Baterai have atau store the chemical energy. Makanya namanya electromagnet. Nah, this is the how you make the electromagnet. They are made by wrapping a copper wire around an iron pole such as a nail. The two ends of the wire are connected to a battery. Nah, dikonekkan ke baterai. When an electromagnet is on, one side of the nail will attract metal like a magnet. Nah, sama seperti magnet. Jadi, kalian nggak punya magnet, kalian bisa memakai ini. Kalau punya baterai, punya iron nail, terus punya wire, nah, kalian bisa pakai ini. Oke. Next. Nah, for the page 4, unit 4.2, if you have any question about the electromagnet, maybe I will give you the picture with the proper wire for the make electromagnet ya nanti ya. Mungkin akan masukkan juga di PPT-nya ini nanti seperti apa sih. Lalu, how you save the energy in your home, maybe look around you. In all in your home have the energy, maybe the light energy and then the wind energy from the fan, but you the fan have apa? Pakai apa juga? Electrical energy from the wall socket. Apa sih? Gimana caranya? How you save the energy? Maybe for Kathleen, how you save the energy in your home? Maybe in the morning you not turn on
the sun
sun
of the room.
Okay, good. You don't have to turn on the lamp. Good. Diganti dengan you change with the sun ya. Kali Kathleen menggunakan cahayanya dari matahari. And then how about Vanessa? How you save your energy in your home? Maybe you can put it down your phone and then I will see you, your face clearly. Nanti micin juga setengah nih. Yeah. Okay. Okay, how you save the energy in your home? Caranya gimana hemat energinya? Maybe not from the light, maybe your water, about the water. How you save the water? No? Masih bingung? Okay, maybe Adli, how you save the energy in your home?
Same with Kathleen, man.
Oh, the same with Kathleen. You use the sun, the light from the sun. Okay, maybe hampir semuanya sama ya kalau pagi ya. Nah, daripada menyalakan lampu, nah lebih baik pakai cahaya matahari, lebih terang ya. Nah, and then maybe like this, switch off appliances at the wall when they are not being used. Nah, kalau tidak menggunakan electrical appliances, cabut aja ya. Itu juga menghemat energi. Misalnya kalian tidak menggunakan magicom atau rice cooker. Nah, my mom not cook some rice atau tidak masak nasi, beberapa nasi. Mungkin magicomnya di rumah ada banyak. Ya, dipakainya salah satu aja ya. Jangan banyak-banyak. Atau kalau ada yang pakai setrika, like mungkin di akhir minggu saja pakai setrikanya. Nggak usah tiap hari. And then like this, if you feel cold, put an extra coat instead of switching on the heating. Nah, kalau kalian merasa kedinginan, nah mungkin ada perapian di rumah. Ada yang punya perapian di rumah? Gak punya ya? Atau bikin api unggun aja di rumah, di depan rumah ya? Nah, gak usah pakai aneh-aneh ya, pakai extra coat aja, pakai ini, you wear the clothes, the extra clothes. And then if you are hot, nah, you don't turn off the air conditioner. The air conditioner nggak usah pakai ini atau nggak usah pakai fan. Udah kipas aja atau have a cold drink water. Nah itu juga bisa menghemat daripada pakai kipas angin atau AC mahal. And then you use energy efficient compact fluorescent bulb, CFL bulbs. Ini apa sih? Lampu hemat energi. Lampu hemat energi karena banyak sekarang model-modelnya ya. Banyak iklan-iklan, lampu hemat energi. Nah, daripada incandescent bulb that was a lot of heat. Jadi daripada yang tidak hemat energi, yang menguras banyak apa? Panas. Jadi cepat habis. Waktunya cepat habis atau waktunya tidak tahan lama. Seperti itu ya. Kalau incandescent itu lampu pijar. Ini lampu pijar ya. Kalau lampu yang ini lampu hemat energi. Seperti kalian bisa lihat incandescent bulb itu lampu pijar itu yang ada ininya ya, masih ada kabel-kabel di dalamnya. Nah, itu lampu pijar. Tapi kalau sudah compact fluorescent bulb itu yang lampu hemat energi. Sekarang banyak. Ya. Nah, itu. Yes, this is the example about the two picture about incandescent in page 78 ya. Di halaman 78 itu adalah contoh lampunya. Nah, okay. This is the how you save the energy. Nah, ini ya. Incandescent, ini lampu pijar. Kalau ini lampu yang hemat energi. Which one in your home? Which one you use in your home? This one or this one? Maybe this one ya. Sekarang sudah mulai ini semua ya. Ya, jarang ada yang ini sekarang. Karena ini sudah jarang ada ditemukan di toko-toko. Sudah sekarang pakai ini karena lebih hemat ya. Okay, how you save the energy? Like this. Nih ya, the main source bisa jadi wall socket atau dari battery more than one cells. Nah, jadi hati-hati dengan ini. Okay, next. Now exercise page 79. Now I want you to prepare your own pencil and then we will answer this question together. For each picture, write a rule. Now, I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5 rules about this activity. How use main electricity safely. Now, for the first picture, already answered like this. Do not put drinks or liquid near electrical appliances. And how about number 2? I have the screwdriver here. And then I have the wall socket. And then the girl insert the screwdriver to or inside the wall socket, and then what the rules for this curve supaya tidak ini gimana? Pakai do not ya.
Not insert anything except for a plug.
Okay, good. Atau ini, yes, good. Do not insert any object into electrical socket other than electrical plugs. Nah, you can write down the answer in your book. Do not insert any object into electrical socket other than electrical plugs. Okay. If you are finished, I want you to thumbs up. I will next for the third picture. If the time 1 minute, I will end this meeting and then we will continue again, yeah, for discuss summary and practice. Okay, and then how about number 3 or the picture C? I have the wall socket and then have so many of the wire or cable. I insert all some of the cable, I think here, yes, to one socket. And what should you do? What's the rules of this?
Do not plug too many wires in attention
to the electricity socket.
Okay, good. Do not plug too many wires in an extension socket at the same time. Do not plug too many wires in extension socket at the same time. Atau in the same place, boleh. Time or place. An extension socket itu apa? Extension socket itu. Socket apa? Cadangan apa? Socket apa? Extension itu maksudnya ya. Ada.
Lebih banyak.
Extension itu lebih banyak. Lebih banyak socket. Ya. Okay, finish. Okay, now D. Nah, I have the wall socket and the cable. And then I directly apa?
Pull
this socket. Have you experiment like this? Have you checked or have you seen the picture about this or the people did like that? Pernah enggak? Christian sering. Yes, betul. Harus dari sini ya. Nah, tapi kalau Miss Jane, kadang-kadang kalau saya sering lupa, ambil kabelnya aja ya. Lebih cepat. Ya, tapi itu berbahaya. It's dangerous. Why? So, what the rules of this? Nah, ini buat Miss Jane ini rules-nya ya. When taking a plug out of a wall, do not pull on the wire. Jangan tarik kabelnya, itu bahaya ya. Nanti malah konslet. Okay, when taking a plug out, saat menarik kabelnya ini atau plugnya ini dari soket, do not pull on the wire directly. Boleh ditambahi directly, secara langsung. Okay, now because the time is limit, I will end this meeting and then we will continue again for the picture E. Yeah. Now, can you see the screen? Not yet. Sudah keluar? Oh, sudah ya. Okay, now for the picture. Sorry tadi ya, udah mati. Okay, so for the picture D, now write the answer. Now to E. Now you use about this. What is that? The hair dryer, yeah, near the bed, near the water in the bedroom. And then what rules of this?
Do not use electricity appliances in wet areas.
In the wet area, or do not use a hair dryer near a bathtub. Atau boleh yang tadi Catherine bilang in the water, water in the water area, boleh near water place, the wet place, sorry, the wet area or the wet place, boleh. Yang lain juga boleh pakai ini aja, nggak apa-apa. Oke. Oh, I see you. Jadi yang missing hari ini hanya Felin ya. Just go with you. Okay. Now next for summary and practice activity, I don't have the slide, but I want you to, or we will discuss it together, yeah. Now when you open your book page 80, halaman 80. Nah, kita akan yes, kita akan jawab bersama-sama ya. Nah, pelan-pelan aja. Nah, for number 1 up to number 20, nah, divided into 3 parts. Page about the subunit 4.1, 4.2, and 4.3. About 4.1, we talk about energy sources in modern world. Jadi kemarin tentang apa? Ada renewable, non-renewable, about the habitat, fossil fuels, and then the pollution. Like that, ya. Now, for number 1, blah blah blah, energy sources cannot be replaced. Jadi cannot be replaced, itu apa berarti?
Non-renewable.
Betul, non-renewable. Nah, Miss Jen akan share ininya saja ya, jawabannya saja, pakai whiteboard. Okay, here. Di sini kelihatan? Sudah whiteboardnya?
Kelihatan.
Kelihatan, oke, di sini. Page. Kok besar sekali, tapi nama. Page 80 for number 1. Non-renewable. Oke, and then for number 2. Petroleum, natural gas, and coal are example of?
Fossil fuels.
Betul, fossil fuels. Okay. And then for number 3. For number 3, mining fossil fuels destroy what?
Habitats.
Habitat. Good, habitats. Destroy habitat, ya. And then number 4, burning fossil fuels can create blah blah blah.
Pollution.
Apa? Burning fossil fuels can affect what? Yes, Lauren. Lauren tadi sama ya, sama kayak Kevin. Pollution. Good. And then for number 5, nah, can be replaced, the energy can be replaced.
Renewable.
Good. And then for number 6, blah blah blah, use wind energy to generate electricity. Nah, kemarin apa?
Wind turbine.
Okay. Now, we want to answer for number 7. Steam from deep inside the earth can turn generator, apa namanya? Generator?
Turbine.
Iya, betul. Akan generate the
generator atau catering generator turbine in power plants. And then for number 8, geothermal power is blah 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 and does not produce gas that cause pollution. Jadi the energy does not produce gas, we can call the blah 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 energy dirty or clean. Yes, clean. The energy does not produce the pollution, we call the clean energy. And then for number 9, atom have a blah 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 at the center. Apa kalau atom kemarin?
Nucleus.
Nah, kalian bisa buka di halaman apa kalau atom kemarin?
Nucleus,
betul. Di halaman berapa? Halaman berapa? Ada ya Miss Jin kemarin ya? Oh, di PPT-nya Miss Jin ya. Nucleus. Nucleus, betul. 10. Number 10. The nucleus is held together by. Ayo, kalau
nuclear energy.
Betul. Nuclear energy. Nah, and then for the nuclear energy, we have the two activity or the two atoms. The activity of atoms. Wow. For number 11 and 12. For number 11, atom combine to make a new atom. Fission or fusion?
Fusion.
Good. And then the split, the atom split?
Fission.
Good. Okay. For number 12 here, yeah. And then for number 13, I miss here. 13. Nah. Nuclear power produce what to about the waste material as the waste material?
Radioactive.
Good. Yang lain juga diket itu ya, ditulis ya. Oke, sebagai bahan ulangannya. And then number 14, the blah 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 happened in Fukushima, destroyed a nuclear plant. Yo, number 14,
tsunami.
Ya, di Jepang ya itu ya. Oke, nah, for number 1, okay, number 14, about the part 4.1 finish. Now, next for the part 4.2, about the invention with electricity and magnetism. We talk about today. Nah, 15. Blah blah blah. Use electricity to attract magnetic object.
Electromagnet.
And then for number 16, you can blah 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 an electrical magnet.
Turn off.
Salah mana ini? Apa sih artinya turn off itu?
Mematikan.
Yeah. And then number 17. Nih, the compact blah 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 lamps are more energy efficient than incandescent lamps. Jadi the opposite of incandescent lamp apa? Lamp?
Fluorescent.
Ini ya. Di poin yang ke ini ya, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. On the left side, the point 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Nah, itu. And then for number 18. Switch blah 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 appliances when you are not using them. Switch?
Off.
Off. Good. Number 19, if we use blah 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 electricity, we connect to the wall socket.
Mains.
Good. For the last one, yang masih belum, blah blah blah, they are used in toys and gadgets and another source electricity.
Cells.
Cells. Good. Now for number 1 up to number 20 finish. Yang belum boleh dicatat dulu. Okay, finish. Okay, now move on for the next page 81. Here, page 81. Number 1. Blah 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 is or a non-renewable source of energy. Apa yang non-renewable di situ?
Fossil fuels.
Betul. Ah ya. Fossil. Yang lainnya apa berarti? Nuclear, geothermal, the sun is the opposite or non-renewable?
Renewable.
Or you can answer clean. Clean energy. Boleh. Boleh pakai clean energy or renewable energy. Sama ya. Next, for number 2. Nah, ini yang tadi Michin bilang. For number 2. Blah, blah, blah. Is a clean energy source.
Nuclear energy.
Nuclear energy. And then, for number 3. To save energy, we should... Nah, ini tadi Kathleen. Seperti contoh Kathleen, apa? To save energy, we should... Yes. C. Open windows during the day. Okay. To let wind or sun win. Bisa tambah ya, boleh. And then number 4, blah 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 is a power plant produce electricity.
Generator.
Banyak yang kemarin kesalahannya di sini. Blah 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 in a power plant produce electricity. Banyak yang ngomong power lines. Padahal power lines itu apa? Yang melewati ya, the pass the power line, pass the power plants pass the power lines. Okay, now B. Sekarang ke B. Tadi yang A ya ini ya. About A. And then how about the B? B part. Nih. The picture that shows safe use of energy. Which one? Mana yang safe? Coba. Titik. A, B, C, D, E, F. Yang mana?
A.
I think this C. C is C what ya? Itu apa tentang apa itu C? I think no ya, because they insert the finger inside the socket. But here. Nah, perbedaannya C and D itu apa? In the wet place and then the dry place ya. Yang C boleh karena dia pakai apa? Sandals. They use or wear sandals. Nah, C boleh karena what is the sandals for about the electricity? Like a sebagai apa? As the conductor or insulator. Sandal.
Insulator.
Insulator, good. And then just A and C ya. E is not good because they directly put on the wire. And then for number F, eat the cable is not good. So for the B part B, A and C, yeah. Okay, now finish for today. Do you have any question? Do you have any question about this? No, ya? Nah, Miss Jin kira sudah selesai. Semuanya sudah paham. Nah, if you have any question about this unit, you can ask me in WhatsApp or Google Classroom. Boleh di stream yang masih belum tahu, ya? Masih belum paham. Okay, now I will
After this, I will send you the PPT, and then for the Zoom meeting, the record, I will send maybe on the evening, ya? Yeah? Di sore-sore aja, karena masih convert, okay? Thank you everyone for today, for joining this class, but we want to lead the prayer for the closing. No one. Okay, Lauren. Okay, now thank you. Here. Now we share this. Now, can you see the screen? Okay, Lauren, you may start.
Friends, let's pray together in the name of the Father, Son, Holy Spirit.
Spirit, amen.
Dear Lord, thank you, Lord, that you have been with us throughout science class and that you are with us right now. Inspire us as we leave this Zoom meeting to love and serve you always. In the name of Jesus, amen.
Mary,
fill me full of grace.
The Lord is with you.
The Lord is with thee. Blessed are thou among women.
And blessed is the fruit of thy womb.
And blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy
Mary, Mother of God,
pray for us sinners now.
Pray for us sinners now and the hour of our death.
Amen. In the name of the Father, of the Son, and the Spirit. Amen. Okay, thank you everyone. Thank you, Grade 6B, for your participation here. And then see you on the 2 weeks later, ya? Yeah? 2 weeks later on the PH4, ya? Yeah? Dicatat di agendanya, okay? Vanessa, iya, PH ya. Okay, thank you everyone. Bye-bye. Okay, bye-bye.
Thank you,
welcome. Bye-bye.